flesh. Here she is now, coming up the mountain path.
Oh, what are we going to say to her?
I don't know.
The poor child. She's probably broken-hearted. You better let me talk to her first.
Well? Come on, Miss Randall, this is your cue.
I'm sorry, I didn't know that you were rehearsing again.
In the theater, Miss Randall, we are supposed to come in on cue.
Yes, but there's some men out there fooling around with ropes and things. Would you ask them to stop?
We find it necessary in the theater to have men fooling around with ropes and things, Miss Randall. But if you just pay more attention to your cues and not contradict so many times, you might get better results.
Well, you needn't be sarcastic about it.
I apologize deeply. Now get out and come in on cue.
All right, don't get excited. I just can't hear anything.
All right, go ahead.
The poor child. She's probably broken-hearted. You better let me talk to her first.
Hello, Mother. Hello, Dad. Hello, Kate. The calla lilies are in bloom again. Such a strange flower, suitable to any occasion. I carried them on my wedding day, and now I place them here in memory of something that has died.
He needs a good thrashing.
You poor child.
Are you gathered here to mourn, or have you come to bring me comfort? You know, there's still something not quite right about that line.
You might learn to read it correctly. That would help.
I don't see why you should object to an intelligent suggestion.
I've written several important plays, Miss Randall. One of them received the Pulitzer Prize. Have you written any plays?
There's an old saying that you don't have to be a hen to know a bad egg.
Now, Miss Randall, there's nothing wrong with a play. Now, I'll explain the scene to you once again. This woman's husband has decided to leave her, and she's broken-hearted. Now, can you understand that?
Yes, I can understand that, but you told me to be light and sophisticated.
On the surface. But inside here, your heart is broken. There's a smile on your face, and you're crying in your heart.
Well, I don't see how you can do two things at the same time.
I refuse to sit quietly by and see my play butchered. Mr. Powell. As long as everyone around here is putting in their 2 cents worth, somewhat promiscuously, I should like to remind you that I have a Broadway reputation to consider.
I don't see what your Broadway reputation has to do with what we're talking about. Give me a light, will you?
Miss Randall.
Hmm?
I'll have to ask you to pay attention to the director.
Well, what am I supposed to do? Walk around like a puppet or use my intelligence?
You're to do as you're told.
Don't yell at me.
I am yelling at you.
Well, If you think I'm so terrible, why'd you hire me for the part?
That's what I'd like to know. Temporary insanity, probably. Now go ahead and do as you're told.
Well,
Go ahead and do it!
I am doing it, but the only thing that I'd just like to make...
How long have you been coaching this girl?
I've only had her a month.
Incredible. No one could possibly get that bad in a month's time.
Would you mind a suggestion?
Anything, please.
I was wondering, could you possibly see an older woman in the part?
I don't know what I'm going to do. Where's this fellow Carmichael? I've got to get out of this contract somehow.
He ought to be here any minute.
There he is now.